you're in class, can you quickly say hi?
Hi.
Okay.
Hi.
Okay. That's better so far.
Actually, three. Network is delaying some persons.
Hi, I'm already in.
Congratulations,
sir. You're welcome, sir.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
There's no light in my place, so NEPA is taking the light.
Ah.
It's okay. It's okay. You're welcome. You're all welcome.
Thank you, man.
Thank you, man.
So we're starting immediately. Like I said before, our topic for this lecture is partnership management. Are we together?
We are, ma.
Okay, so we're talking on partnership management. And in that topic, partnership management, we have so many terms in that topic. We have partnership, and then we have management. And, you know, before we partnership, it's something called a partner. Before we get to the term partnership, are we together?
Yes, ma'am. We are together.
Okay. So first of all, we would like to know who a partner is before we go to the term partnership. So a partner is any individual. Partner can be an individual, can also be an institution. So when you hear the term, you don't just think it's only a human being that is a partner. Partner can be an individual, can be an institution. It can be a donor. It can even be, when we say institution, it can be the government. The government can also be your partner. So a partner is either an individual or an institution, which includes government, donors, companies, whose active participation and support is essential for the successful running of any business. Yes, either for the successful running of a business or the implementation of a project or a program. That's what a partner or who a partner. I don't know if we've gotten that point. So.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So the next thing we'll be going into is partnership. Since we've already known who a partner is, we'll now like to know what partnership is. So partnership is a formal arrangement by two or more parties to either manage and operate a business or to implement a project. And then at the end of the day, end up sharing its profits or its loss. In every business, it's either you gain or you lose. You know, most times people just go into partnership and all they have in their head is the profit they make. They don't really look at the loss aspect. So in every partnership you enter, you either know that you share both all the legal and the financial liabilities equally or proportionally as the case may be, as your agreement from the onset. Yeah, so partnership is the formal arrangement by two or more parties to manage and operate a business, to implement a project, and they end up sharing either its profits or its losses. So from there, we'll be going to our topic for the day, partnership management. Since we've gotten a little knowledge of what partnership and who a partner is, now I want to go into partnership management. I want to know what partnership management is. So I don't know if we're on the same page.
Yes, ma'am. Very loud and clear.
Okay. So now partnership management is the process of following up on maintaining effective, productive, and harmonious relationship within partners or with partners. So it's a process whereby you follow up on maintaining effective, productive, and harmonious relationship within partners. So in essence, I'll try to say in partnership management, you don't just follow up on maintaining effective and productive business or just trying to make sure the business is successful, the business is effective or it's productive. It also goes a long way to follow up on maintaining harmonious relationship within partners. So that's what partnership management means. That means if I'm into partnership with you and I want to gain or manage our partnership, I will not just look at trying to make sure the business is successful, it goes well, and we don't run losses at the end of the day. I will also try to look into how we as partners can have a harmonious relationship, a very good relationship, even in the partnership. So this class is not going to be taking too long, because I don't really have much to say, but I hope you understand what I'm saying.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am, we're understanding you.
I think, do we just have two persons in this class?
Yes, ma'am, I'm understanding you.
Yes, when I hear a lady like me, I'll have the guts to continue. So, all right, now we'll be looking at strategic ways of maintaining partnership, strategic ways of partnership management. We're now going to look at ways we can manage partnership properly, strategic ways of partnership management. So first of all, one of the first, I think we have about 8 or 9 of them. Of course, our time will let us talk about. So the first thing we'll be talking, the first strategic way of partnership management we'll be talking about is to establish a clear foundation, to establish a thing we look at in every partnership. You know, sometimes when people go into partnership, and because they just struggle to strike a deal or probably hit the target or make the profit they want to make or they plan to make, they don't just settle down to set a clear foundation. When I say clear foundation, it simply means where we'll come down, where we'll come before, where we'll come to discuss before we go. We're all different as human, we're all different as human beings. And because we're different, our goals or our means for entering into different business, entering into businesses are different. Our motivation, what drives us in entering into business is different. I might enter into business just to make profit. And Mr. B might enter into that business for longevity, like to make sure that that business continues to grow. Like the person is not just looking at the now. The person is looking at where this business will be in. Meanwhile, me, Mr. Miss A, I'm actually looking at how I can just make quick profit in that business at that point in time. So that's where establishing a clear foundation comes in, where everybody comes, sit down, everybody who is involved, each partner that is involved in that partnership comes and then sit down and discuss clearly on the goal we want to achieve in that particular partnership or in that particular business. Where I come and I say, okay, why I'm entering into this business is just for me to make profit. And then Mr. B says, okay, the reason why he or she is entering into this partnership is for him or her to expand his or her own business. Uh-huh. Why another person is entering into the partnership for future purpose, not just for the now, but because the person is looking at the situation where the business can grow into other aspects in the nearest future. So it is very, very necessary that everybody comes together and discuss before the business kicks off or starts, and discuss all what they want to derive or what they want to achieve from that business. And in doing that, Transparency is actually needed. Transparency is one of the necessities when trying to set a clear foundation for a partnership. Yes. You know, when transparency is involved, it creates trust and understanding too. Yes, because when I come and I tell you, this is my main aim of going into this business, and you understand that this is my main aim of going into this business, I also understand your own aim, we'll work with the goal each of us have in mind. So transparency has a very big role to play in establishing a clear foundation. You come and then be open and say what you want to achieve. It's not because probably you think, I want to go into partnership with this person and this person is my friend, or I have much respect for this person. And then maybe this person is looking at this too. Maybe the person is looking at a dynamic kind of business. Business that will not just end here. Business that will continue to last for ages. And me, I want profits for now. Maybe because of the kind of respect I have for the person, I will not be open to say, this is actually what I want in this business. And probably it's now warrant me going behind the person to probably look for other means to get my, or what I want for that business without the person's consent. That's why you see most partnership crash. It will not reach even the, it will not reach the appointed time when that partnership is supposed to end. And then you just see the partnership crash halfway because there is no transparency in discussing our goals when we're setting the clear foundation for the business. I don't know if we've gotten that point.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, we've gotten it.
Okay. So,
yes, ma'am.
All right. So we should try to establish a clear foundation in every partnership to avoid problem at the end of the day. So the second strategy, nurture the heart, starts well from the very beginning, and at the long run, the partnership will just start having loopholes and cracking because partners are not able to nurture the relationship in the partnership. I think from the next point, I will understand clearly what I mean by nurturing the relationship in the partnership. So that will lead us to the next point, which is connecting socially. Yeah. Sometimes when we go into partnership, we're just focused on the business, on making profit, and we don't just try to know each other's lapses or the other areas of, or the other way of life of our fellow partners. So in partnership, one of the major ways to manage partnership is to connect socially. Connect socially. Once in a while, you go out with your partners, people who are your partners in business. You go out with them, you try to discuss outside the business to know probably what is going on in the person's life and all of that. Yeah. But so do you nurture the relationship of the partnership. The person will know that apart from this business, apart from your own particular goal in your heart, which you want for this particular, which you want to get from this particular partnership, you still have them in mind. You see, it helps your partner to put in his or her best into the partnership. So let's try to connect socially. That's another key point, another strategic way of partnership management. Is to connect socially, and then also talked about to nurture the relationship. Then the next one is to keep everyone in the loop. Keep everyone in the loop. There is something we did not really talk about when we talked about partnership or partners. There are actually two types of partnership, which is the general partners, and then the limited. In the general partnership business, every partner is involved both in the running of the business, and then the profits and losses are being shared equally, even the liabilities, both legal and financial liabilities. But if it comes to a limited partnership, in the limited kind of partnership, we have two types of partners. There is a general partner and then the limited partner. The general partner puts in both his money and even his time in the running of the business. But the limited partner only puts in, is like an investor. Yes, he only invests his money into the business and not his time. And then at the end of the day, even when the business crashes or winds up, you discover that limited partner has nothing much to lose in the partnership. So for one of the strategic way for partnership management, one of the strategic way of partnership management is to keep everyone in the loop. Like in the situation where you have limited partners who are not engaged in the daily running of the business, you have to keep them in the loop, keep them informed of everything that goes on in the daily operation of the business. I think I am in that kind of partnership right now with somebody where the person brings in his money. Majorly, it is his money in the business. And my money is just small. And I'm the one doing the running around for the business. But from time to time, I keep him informed about everything. Like if we have, okay, for example, what we sell is yam. What I sell is yams. I carry yams. So when we have maybe one tuber of yam, that's point of the way. I have to call him and say, see, we have one tuber of yam that's quite on the wheel and all of that. I try to keep that person in the loop so that at the long run, when we start having losses, the person is already informed about the several circumstances that led to that loss. So we should try to keep everyone in the loop. And then another way, strategic way of partnership management is to recognize each other's capabilities and their motivation. Yes, in partnership management, there are people who are capable of producing. If it's in an industry where they produce, there are people who, like maybe where you have two or more firms coming together in a partnership. There is a firm that is good in production, and then there's a firm that is good in marketing. So when you recognize each other's capability and motivation, you will not make the mistake of giving production to a firm that knows how to market very well. It helps you to know when to who and who to give each responsibility to, which will in turn make the business to grow well. Are we on the same page?
Clearly, ma'am. Very clearly.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
And then the next one. Okay. And then the next one is emphasize on accountability. Emphasizing on accountability. You make sure that in every partnership, you account for everything that goes on in the business. You account for everything that goes on in the business. Even in our small partnership as students, I don't know if we've experienced a situation where you engage in, where you are in a friend business together. You account for everything, even if you're the one in the field running the business. And the other person is just bringing in the money. You try to account for everything that goes on in the business for to avoid loopholes and problems at the end of the day. And then another strategic way of partnership management is to plan for transitions, to plan for transition ahead of time. You plan in a situation where you know that maybe we're starting up Motion Create Niger. Let me use Motion Create Niger as an example. I know one time Motion Create Niger started with making of bow tie, lapel, and all of that. But it's been discussed among the partners in Motion Create Niger that at some point we train people on how to produce products too. And then at some point, we'll plan for transitions, possible transitions that business might go through at the long run. You don't just look at the now. You look at the areas where the business will expand to in the nearest future. And then you discuss about it from the onset. so that some people will not feel left behind at the long run. So you should try to plan for transition and then determine governance too. Yes, you know, when a society, let's say when a society is lawless, people tend to misbehave the more. So in a partnership, you also determine governance. People who will actually lead this partnership, people who, it's not where in a situation where everybody acts according to the way they want. No, it should be a particular, how do I put it? A particular laid down governance for every partnership. And then you build on a dynamic partnership. Lastly, you build on a dynamic partnership. That's the last one for today. You build on a dynamic partnership. That means you don't just look at partnership that you just hit a particular goal and then everybody goes their way. No, you look at partnership when you're trying to go into partnership. You look at partnership. Despite the challenges that will come in years to come, partnership that can stay for a very long time. Partnership that can stay and
okay. Our lecturer is having network challenges. I don't know if you noticed, she just went offline.
Hopefully she has been breaking all the way for some while now.
Yes. Yes. She's back on. Let's see.
She's back.
Yes, sir. Hello, Mark. Can you hear us?
Oh, sorry. I think I was disconnected. Hello.
We are with you, my 100%.
Okay. So I said the next we'll be looking at is in terms of partnership management. So one of the major importance of partnership management is that it ensures a project or a business stays on track. It ensures that the business stays on track and not deviates from the initial plans of that particular business or that particular project. And then another thing is that it ensures that the goal of every project or every business is being achieved. And partnership is not just all about, it's also about losses. But when we try to manage our partnership carefully, it now helps to ensure that the goal of almost every partner in the partnership and the particular goal for that project or that business is being achieved. And so in summary, I'll try to say that for every partnership to grow well, it should be managed properly in the various ways mentioned so far, establishing a clear foundation, nurturing the relationship, connecting socially, keeping everyone in the loop, recognizing each other's capabilities and motivation, emphasizing on accountability, and then planning for transition, determining governance, and then building a dynamic partnership. And then lastly, I want to say that Partnership management can also be either formal or informal. Informal in the sense that it can be through phone calls, emails, and social visits. And then formal also in the sense that it can be written as agreement can review periodically in the process of the partnership. So partnership management can either be informal or formal. And I think with that, we've come to the end at this point. I don't know if anyone has a question or we all understood what I've said so far. You are confused in some area. I think Mr. Shedda could take over from here.
Thank you very much. If you have a question, I think we have some time. You can ask the question here. Let's see how it goes. And I hope some of us have been able to connect, because although the network has not been stable, but I think I've been able to get one or two points. But if you have been following the class and you have any question you would love to ask, there's time and there's room for that to ask here. Because after this class, we'll be going for our second class briefly. So any question?
Hello, good evening, class.
Good evening, sir.
Minister.
Yes. I just want to ask a question. Take, for instance, you have an idea. Maybe it's a tech idea, maybe a software application you want to design to solve a problem. And then, you know, you have, let's say you need a good team, and then maybe one person in the team. You've tried everything according to the steps that you've said to try to, like, you want them to be like a team, people that will help you build the idea and build the vision. And, you know, one of them is always insisting, before you say something, he will say, let's sign a legal document. Any small thing, let's sign a legal document. You bring up an idea. He has not contributed, let's say, much to the team, but he is all about shares, all about percentage. The dream have not even kicked off yet, and he's always asking those kind of questions. If you were the leader of the team, he's seeking partnership. What do we advise, let's say, to the team head as regarding the issue? I don't know if you understand my question.
Okay, can you repeat it again? Let me understand clearly.
Okay, so you have a team, right? You have an idea. The idea has not taken off yet. It has not materialized per se.
Mm-hmm.
And you're still building. And, you know, there's somebody on your team that at everything you say, he's always seeking. There is partnership. You have a team. It's the goal, maybe at the end of the day, is that you guys will reach some sort of partnership, right? But then every little thing you're saying, he's not ready to contribute until something is signed on paper, you know, the legal, every small thing. You say, let's call my lawyer, let's do this one on paper and all that. And let's say if you're a team head of those kind, let's say you want to design a software application and all that. If you are the team head for that kind of arrangement and you have somebody on your team always insisting, law, then what will you recommend or what will you advise?
Okay, I think in that situation, from the first point, which you said, we should establish a clear foundation. So, in where you have somebody who is always
Hello, ma'am. We can't hear you. Hello, ma'am.
Saying on the the person's totally different from in that situation. You're not working with. Can you hear me?
You were breaking and coming up. I was even about to suggest whether you can drop a voice note on the answer, maybe later on also.
Oh, yeah. And our network has gone off. With your permission, sir, I would like to attempt that question.
No problem, sir.
All right. One major thing, partnership is founded on is trust. And if you discover that whosoever you are getting into partnership with has this trust issue, it is very, very wise for you to be guided and use the formal pathway. Now, the law can bind a lot of contracts, can bind a lot of things. So it's actually a wise step for somebody to introduce a legal approach to any partnership. Now, probably now that person feels, or maybe that person is not yet satisfied with the trust level on ground. And again, the person has seen that this vision is actually true. It can actually do a lot. It can go a long way. The possibilities are high. So in order not to be on the losing side, because you know some people can actually be very smart. They can play a fast one on you. It will get you in the picture. And if you are so engrossed with the positivity, you don't, should I say, put yourself in as well. You might just miss out on everything. So whosoever is taking that approach, number one, I would like to say the person is wise. But again, the person might not be, now you can't trust everybody. Everybody can't be friends. Even the people we call friends, we're not 100% sure if they can have our backs when we need them the most. So for that person to introduce that law, should I say the legal environment into the picture, it's a wise step. Now it's left for whosoever is pioneering the vision to handle it well, which I believe in the first place, there should be a legal document. Because if somebody is bringing money, another person is bringing idea, another person is developing the app, since we're talking about the software application, these are all functional parts of the business. And majorly, the person bringing in the money is like the biggest risk taker. And if the person bringing in the money is the person demanding for a legal tendency, a legal form to come out, that person is extremely wise. But and again, a partnership, I believe, must be a group of persons who understand their value and they are bringing it together to come to a logical end. So if they have agreed within themselves, and okay, if this is how it will go, let's sign this document. If we start making profits, it's either we reinvest it or probably we share some percentage. That is one. And again, you can say that, all right, I am the head of the project. I will give you people a share. Let it be put into writing. Imagine Facebook in 2004, he shared this idea with 5 of his friends. I think just 3 or 2 bought the ideas. And those 2 are multi-billionaires with him. I don't know why the other person didn't buy the idea. Probably trust was the issue. But those 2 persons, they bought into their idea. And I believe they invested together. Because I personally am in a partnership of similar nature and between friends. Let me say for now, we trust ourselves. The big, big money is not yet coming in to start bringing doubt and all of that. But for now, we trust ourselves. But the issue is that we don't have any legal documents on ground. We just told ourselves that once this YouTube channel start paying, we contributed so amount of money. So we'll find a way to share it. That's on the platform of trust, basically. All right. I don't know if I think I've attended the question, sir. Sir, did I give it a try?
Yes, sir. You attempted it perfectly well. Thank you, sir. God bless you.
Thank you, sir.
Because at the time, what I asked was that at the time, you will start feeling as though the person doesn't believe in the vision, or as though the person doesn't trust the vision, or is not patient with the process. You just want to, you know, just sign any small thing law. And the keep vision has not kicked off yet. And you want us to bind. I don't know if you're understanding me. The person is suggesting you bind everything in the contract, you sign everything and all that. So I just wanted to ask to have like your perspective and your perception on the whole thing. It's a form of partnership, but you know, it's too early. I feel as though in a way that it's too early to jump certain process and all that. But as from what you've said now, it's good you start actually with a legal document so that everybody is clear. The foundation is clear. Everybody knows that this is what they are going for. And then they attend to it professionally because they know it's something right now that is a serious business.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
And also, If we're talking about friends here, people who have grown up together or they have seen things together, they have understood themselves, and they feel that they can control themselves when and they start making the money, there's no problem delaying the legal document, as long as they can trust themselves that much. It's all about trust at this point for me. Yes, ma'am.
All right, sir.
Speaker, you have something to say before the class ends? We just have 3 minutes. Miss Mercy.
Okay, everybody has answered. Yes, can you hear me?
Yes, we can.
I can hear you.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, we can.
I can.
Okay. Mr. Shady has already given a right answer to that question. I was trying to say that in the first place, partnership is about a formal arrangement. Everything needs to be formal. So when a person is actually asking for signing legal document, the person is on the right track. Yes. Except it's not a serious partnership. You're not looking forward to start a very serious partner. But for every serious partnership is a formal arrangement. And when an arrangement is formal, that means everything has to be legal. So the person is on the right track. In fact, there are some people that for them to trust any partnership, everything has, so it's still part of establishing a clear foundation. Thank you.
All right. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it.
Thank you very much, ma'am. We just have 2 minutes. So we are going off to come back immediately. The same link. It's a reoccurring event, so reoccurring meeting. The same link, we'll click on it. The meeting will start again. By the grace of God, we won't take more than 30 minutes so that we can close up on the class we had network issues with on Monday. So thank you and see you in the next class immediately. God bless you.
Thank
you very much, ma'am.
God bless you, ma'am. I really appreciate you, ma'am.
Thank you.
God bless you.